My name is Ralph. I'm a movie freak. A Polish art film, Pazanski. Milos Pederastniki. There's a director. Great reviews. Boy, oh boy, what a scene. Oh, it's going to be an exciting night at the Flicks, folks.
The new people. I wonder what Cary Grant would have made of that one.
Oh, this place is so chic, they don't even sell popcorn. Alfalfa sprouts! Oh, my God. Oh. Sunflower seeds. Now, that's what I call chic. God, no. It's just like her. It's Josephine Cosnowski. It's Josephine Cosnowski all over again. Oh, no. Did I ever tell you about Josephine Cosnowski? My desperate escape into the night?
It all began here in that great inverted bowl of darkness. That Stygian bowl of Omar Khayyam. The Midwest. I was working part-time in the steel mill. Running, always running, running. Delivering the mail. Holman, Indiana. Clinging like a barnacle to the underbelly of Chicago. Along the shore of Lake Michigan. 30 below in the winter. 110 degree blast furnace heat in the summer. A good place to learn about hell. Our little cast was assembled. Mom in the kitchen. Her private hell. The old man, he always said, there has to be a God if there's beer. All that goodness ain't just accidental. There are all kinds of religions. My kid brother Randy, the newest Cub Scout in the block, he remained one all of his life. Fuzzhead, the canine vacuum cleaner. She could scoff up food faster than our Electrolux. Me, Ralph, as a kid, I remember that Thanksgiving more than any other, and for good reason.
They're back. I knew it. God damn it. I knew they'd be back. Would you look at that? Oh, no. Son of a gun. Damn it.
That fateful Thanksgiving began 6 weeks before with a bumpus scare. The old man went crazy.
The first bumpus that spits tobacco juice in our driveway, I'm gonna...
The shiftless bumpus clan had lived next door for a hellish 4 months. Ah, the old man hated them like rattlesnakes, a pack of varmints that made the Tobacco Road crowd look like the cream of Palm Beach. They had moved out like skunks in the night 3 months back, leaving unpaid rent, a yard full of garbage, and three mangy hounds named Old Blue. Civilization had returned to the neighborhood. And now...
They're at it already. Listen to that.
That's not Hank Williams. Shh. Hey, what's that smell? Boy, smells good.
I say, that is stuffed cabbage. Polish style.
Well, this is not them stinking hog jowls and boiled possum, those bumpus slobs stuffed down their traps.
The scent of stuffed cabbage wafted on a soft breeze is dangerously erotic. A new chapter in my life had begun. John's, our favorite hamburger joint. A steamy, ratty, greasy spoon 3 blocks from the school. John himself, a disappointed man who viewed life with all the éclat of a grizzly. With an impact of wisdom, too.
Ah, the rich aroma of cotton.
Oh, no, not them again.
Hi, Esther Jane.
Hi, Ralph.
Struck out again, old buddy.
Rice?
Yeah, and a lemon coke.
A sophisticated selection. Make it 2.
I don't want no trouble for you.
John, my good man, you suffer from a lack of humor. A little yawk here.
Look, kid, you pour salt in that sugar thing one more time, and I'll kick your butt all the way to Calumet City. You won't even have time to bounce.
Touchy, touch. Give me a tuna salad sandwich.
On a bun?
Yeah, and a marshmallow Coke.
2 cheeseburgers and tuna on a bun, eh? I've got my eye on you, kid.
Already, Flick was headed down the rocky path. His later career of shifty real estate scams, dealing blackjack in Vegas, seedy hotel rooms, and hasty flights from the law was just over the horizon. Good old Schwartz. Not really a loser, certainly not a winner. One of life's flubbers.
You know that house next door to us?
Where Delta Bumpus lived? They had all them crazy dogs.
And Cassie, when she got back from the reformatory, what a pair of ducks she had.
I thought they took a powder.
They did. And you'll never guess what's moved in. Let me guess. The Three Stooges. A Polish family from East Chicago. And they got a daughter named Josephine. A Polish girl named Josephine. Holy smokes.
Polish girls were the stuff of legend in our set. Exotic, remote. The lure of the alien and foreign is always strong. We used to take Flick's car and ride through the Polish neighborhoods just to see the girls on summer nights.
Holy smokes. Look at that one in the middle. Boy.
Josephine.
Yep. Josephine Cosnowski. Real thing.
Oh, boy. I was in the grip of a classic case of girl madness. I had seen her twice in the distance, and my mind virtually reeled. It isn't easy trying to look casual, carrying a double B-flat sousaphone over your shoulder. The first rule of girl stalking is to be cool. You never know which way they'll jump. The bluebird. Need more be said? Haven of hopes, dreams, and furtive adulteries. Also, the best draft beer in the entire Calumet region.
Mother's milk, eh?
First of the day and badly needed.
Yay!
And a waitress in the back.
Put a meter on that and sell it.
No more friendly lies and no more time to hear.
see you've finally cleaned the bar, right?
I'm back in me hand here.
Say, Gertz.
Mm.
You been by Friendly Fred's used car lot lately?
No. Something good on the lot?
Good. You won't believe it. His used car lot was in the classic American tradition. A bastion of worn valves, leaky head gaskets, and balsa wood transmissions, all accompanied by the air of the Carnival Midway. Gaiety and fun rampant. Fred was ready to make a deal on anything at any time in spades.
What is it?
Well, I've been driving by there all this week. He has an absolutely perfect Buick Roadmaster. A hydromatic drive with floating power.
Absolutely mint. Come on, a total cream.
Of course, the only trouble is the old lady. Of course.
What did you say, this lady?
Hey, watch it, Gertz.
I don't want the bugger to know we're interested in
her. My old man was a lifelong used car buyer. He loved the challenge of the hunt, the possibility of disaster. He always said, any fathead can pick up a new car. You gotta know what you're doing to pick up a good used one. He and Friendly Fred, the hungry gypsy, had been locked in mortal combat for years.
It's the one up on the platform. Thanksgiving special.
Huh?
Oh, there it is. Look at that baby. Isn't that a beauty? What did I tell you? I've been doing a little investigating. That baby was owned by a Presbyterian minister with arthritis who only drove it on Sundays.
What does the old lady say?
Well, I've been dropping a few hints.
Good luck, buddy.
Right next door, a Polish girl. A wave of ecstasy shuddered through my frame in the darkness. That night, I began my lonely hunt of the mysterious Josephine Cosnowski. Captain Ahab's first sighting of Moby Dick. The mysterious forces that drive us to the precipice are barely understood. But to all of us comes a day when we lay aside childish pleasures and go after truly big game. The moth headed for the flame. The mills of the gods have begun to grind.
And if you don't stop that whining, I'll give you something to whine about.
Aww.
Did you hear me?
Yeah.
A kid.
Just once. Just once. I wish we had one paid for before we get the next one.
I know. But this is different. It's a real cream puff.
Ma, I can't find my shoes.
It's got hydromatic.
Go upstairs and look for it.
Hey, Gertz, I gotta run. I'll be late for the goddamned office.
Mom!
Hold your water, Gertz. I'm coming.
Bowman High. Three stories of red brick, fear of failure, wild passions, and occasionally, just occasionally, education. My alma mater.
You guys got your tickets for the Horace Mann game yet?
I'm thinking of mine today.
I got Horace Mann at 8 points.
You're betting on Horace Mann?
Dough is dough.
Betting on Horace Mann was a little like shooting one of Santa's reindeer and having his head mounted over the pinball machine in your den with a plaque reading Blitzen.
You really are a skunk. Listen, you guys. I gotta go down to the office.
In a crowd. I was a champagne cork going over Niagara Falls. Oh, there she is. Oh, passion, the glory and the curse of mankind.
What's eating him?
Search me.
One thing I hate about this time of the year, he always gets bit by the new car bug. Oh, I don't know. You know, sometimes I think all men are crazy, especially about cars. I don't know what they see in them. Oh, there's a peanut butter and jelly sandwich on the table. Look. Irma, I've got to call you back. Randy just came home. Oh, it's fine. Now, you pick up that lunchbox. Just who do you think you are? Now, you pick it up, you hear me? March. Now, you sit right here and you tell me what's bothering you and cut out the whining.
Well...
did you have trouble in school today?
I'm a turkey.
You're a what?
It's not funny.
What do you mean, you're a turkey?
Thanksgiving play. Michelle said I'm a turkey.
Now, being a turkey isn't so bad.
Jimmy's a pilgrim, and so is it Cliffy. And Sunday's an Indian.
Already, the kid was suffering from alphabetical ghetto. Dougie's last name was Adams. Gammy's last name was Baker. Randy, like me, was squatting in the back of the room in the last third of the alphabet among the P's and the Z's and the W's. Naturally, he was a turkey. He was lucky to get in the play at all.
You're going to be the best turkey they ever saw at Warren.
Hear that ticking sound? This baby's starting to go.
I like the old Hudson.
Mm-hmm. Soon we'll be throwing good money after bad.
What did you say?
Aren't you listening to me?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was thinking about Randy's turkey costume.
Turkey costume? Turkey costume.
For school.
Turkey costume. Huh? You hear that? Hear that knock? This baby is starting to go.
Pass the bridge mix, Frida.
Every week, my mother and her cutthroat gang of card sharks gather to play bridge, eat bridge mix, and roast their absent friends.
Every day she goes past the house all dressed up on her way to the bookie.
All those lovely ones sitting in your teeth.
How can she afford it? I mean, math hasn't worked in 6 months at least.
Harry says she won $500 on one race last week.
$500?
No, that's always the way.
Wouldn't you know it?
Frida, are you going to the PTA Thanksgiving pageant? Mm-hmm. Phillies and Indians.
Poor Randy the turkey. And I haven't any idea what kind of a costume to fix up. I mean, I don't even know where to start.
Say, why don't you come home with me and we'll ask my sister Gladys about how to make a turkey suit.
Oh, she's here from New York.
Goodness. She's still redhead.
Gladys was Mrs. Thompson's legendary sister who had gone to New York, studied art, ate lobsters, smoked brown cigarettes, went to the theater. Obviously, she could do anything.
She makes her own lampshades.
She's so smart.
What a good idea.
Hey, Beach Ball, what president had a name beginning with a P?
Polk?
Polk. Never heard of him. Are you kidding me? No, it's got six letters.
He's President Pierce.
We had a president named Pierce? Oh, you're thinking of that White Sox pitcher, Pierce. Billy Pierce.
Franklin Pierce.
It fits. See that girl next door, yeah? What a looker.
Yeah, she's all right.
Goodbar. I wonder if there's a Mrs. Goodbar, huh?
Okay, you guys gonna screw around? Go down to Mattingly's and get your damn candy bars.
Legendary Howie. Six foot six, three-time All-State home and high forward, future All-American, NBA star. Until Stella. Crazy in love. He dropped out of school, got married, two kids. And now, he's slaving away his life at Aschenschlager's Cash and Carry.
Now, who do you pick for the Horace Mann game? Think we'll beat him by more than 8 points?
We'll cream him. 30 points, at least.
Josie. You help me carry my groceries home, huh?
Excitements in life are those first moments with a new love. She is like an unexplored continent stretching endlessly to the horizon. Oh boy.
Tell me why you're pouring milk on your meatloaf.
The madness was beginning to show. Indiana has one true religion, basketball. Washington could be atom bombed, and it wouldn't make the papers during the high school state tournament finals. Oh, I loved it all. I couldn't think of anything else. Basketball.
Helen's later and use her sewing machine. My darn machine is broken again. That thing makes me so mad.
You and me are going over to Friendly Fred's Wednesday night and close the deal for that Buick.
That's nice.
Did you hear what I said?
Of course. And then afterwards, we can go to PTA pageant.
Hydromatic. Floating
power. That's nice.
A cream puff.
At crazy times of the day, my mind would suddenly go out to lunch. Get hot and cold flashes. My fellow workers were beginning to notice.
Hey, Ralph, come on, let's go. Get your ass in here.
Josie?
Yes? Party with me?
Oh, yes, of course. Of course, Josie, darling.
This is very serious, Ralph.
Oh, anything. Anything.
Wednesday night.
Oh. Wednesday night? The Horace Mann game. Oh, the biggest game of the year. Holy smokes.
Oh, of course. Oh, Josie.
Wednesday night.
fateful Wednesday was off and running.
Ouch!
Schwartz and Flick were already on their way to the Civic Center for the big game.
Hey, Applejack, you want to go over with us to pick up the new car?
I can't.
What?
I can't. I'm gonna go to the game.
Okay. See you later, Rat Trap.
For the first time, I was about to enter a new world, as remote from my mother's kitchen as Indianapolis is from Baghdad. All this religious stuff. What the devil? They live in the basement.
Josephine from Lincoln.
Would you look at that? They live in the basement.
You, Ralph? My brother Alex. Tackle. Offensive. Hiya.
Notre Dame. Of course.
Sit down, buddy.
It's Killer and Bubba Cosnowski. Her brothers.
And now, play with Lord Killer Bart Cosnowski. And then, the set.
You Ralph?
Her old man's got a beard.
Yeah.
Eat? You hungry? Eat. Josephine make good cook. Make fine wife.
Uh-huh. That's where that smell's coming from.
No thanks. I already had supper.
Hey, Josie! Your man's here! Josie like you. Good.
You just look at her.
Boy, your stuffed cabbage smells great.
Wait till you try my pierogies.
I was 10 feet tall and growing by the second. Tonight, I was a man. I could take up tobacco chewing anything. This was my woman. Those poor, stupid boobs Schwartz and Flick at that dumb basketball game. Greasy kid stuff. This was my woman.
Ralph, I'm so happy.
Oh, boy.
We'll be so happy together.
Yeah.
Holy smokes. Where is this party anyway? Westminster Abbey? What the devil? It's a church. Oh, no, it can't be. A church. My God, it's in the basement of the church. The party's in the basement of the church.
Josephine has said so much about you. You're a lucky man. We have all been looking forward to meeting you.
Yeah, thanks. Boy, this sure is some party. Father?
It wasn't easy calling someone father. I didn't even call the old man then.
Enjoy yourself. This sure is some party.
Clement,
Tell you, there's nothing that'll put you into shape quicker than 10 choruses of the Dawn Patrol polka.
Would you look at that beauty? Would you just look at it?
Nah, it is pretty.
Man, you sure know cars.
Oh, Mr. Hudson.
And now for you, my little man. Here's some Fredzy Fred Monkey.
Me too. 40-inch soaking pit.
You don't mess around with guys who work in the 40-inch soaking pit. They can bend railroad iron with their bare hands.
Good boy.
Stosh and Alex were the first at the trough.
Put more sauces over here.
Come on, Stosh. You gotta put the wearing off.
Oh, come on.
Thank you. Wait till Gert sees this baby. Would you listen to that? Would you listen to that radio? Air conditioning? Wait till this summer. These wipers. See that? They squirt water. This thing rides as smooth as a baby's butt. Oh, boy, can feel that.
My. This sure is nice.
Right, 5-piece living room suite with the footstool. Just right for you kids. You can have it at my cost. Anything for Josie and her man, eh?
Hey, Howie! How you doing, boy?
You know Howie?
Yeah, sure.
That's his wife, Stella. We went to All Saints together. She's pregnant again.
There was something in the way she said that sent a faint chill up my spine. the ironclad law of the used car jungle. You don't take nothing back. Until my mother got into the act.
Here are the keys to Hudson.
But you can't take a used car back.
I did. Let's go. Well, we're off to the PTA pageant.
I don't want to see no turkey.
The hell with a PTA turkey. I'm going to the Bluebird.
What did he say then?
Well, he had to admit that I knew cars, and he couldn't pull a fast one on me.
Where'd the old lady at?
Oh. She wanted to keep it just because of the car.
I told her no way.
Hey, women, what do they know about cars?
Amen.
I had no more idea what kielbasa was than your average Eskimo knows about sweet and sour coleslaw, but I plunged ahead. Well, let me tell you, Polish food has got to be among the world's sexiest. Talk about erotic. Oh, boy. Polish sausage, kielbasa, stuffed cabbage. Gee.
Run for it, buddy. Run for it.
What?
Run for it now. She introduced you to the priest. Don't you know what that means? Her relatives? That's how it happened to me. And if you don't... Run for it, man. Now. She introduced you to the priest. Don't you know what that means? Her relatives?
Very serious, Ralph.
That's how it happened to me.
Oh, I'd be so happy.
Run for it, man. Now.
My chaotic life, I had stared into the grim face of adulthood. Crying babies, diaper bags. Thank God. I had to get out now. All I wanted was a date, not a wife.
Out for a little air, Ralph, old boy.
Yeah, Stosh. Yeah, breath of air, Stosh. Just breath of air.
I think that little bugger's trying to run out on Josie.
Hey, you! Where you think you're going?
Come on. You hit him high. I'll hit him low.
Get him!
Come on, Alex, damn it!
my terror, I ran a 2.5-minute mile. Insane fear and crying babies lent wings to my feet. I became an Olympic gold medalist that night. I was a kid again.
Oh, boy, look at that sweat. The boys drove or something, eh, buddy? You know it. What's the score?
We got about 35 points. Last quarter, 8 minutes to go.
How's Kovac doing?
26 points so far.
What a dull game.
The moth had come close to the flame. It was the first time for me. Ah, there would be other flames, but that was in the future. Mom became the Picasso of the neighborhood. Kid brother was a total smasheroo as a turkey. It was his first and only taste of applause. He did not know it, of course, but this was the high point of his life.
Smell of turkey. Mmm, that smells good.
Thanksgiving dinner was magnificent, as usual. Randy refused to take off his turkey suit. He wore it for 2 weeks afterwards, even when he was taking his bath.
Okay, how is everything?
Everything
huh?
Looks wonderful.
Did you taste the turkey yet?
No, not yet.
Hey, I want you to take my stuffing. That's my new recipe.
Well, I think you can help yourself. You've got that little thing in there.
Mm.
You want the corn?
Yeah, lots of corn.
How about some
potatoes? From sea to shining sea, Thanksgiving, as always, was celebrated by inhaling trillions of calories. Rich and poor alike dipped into the mashed potatoes, the string beans, the candied yams of American patriotism. 37 million turkeys fulfilled their destiny gloriously. Then the desserts. Down the tubes went countless diets.
Okay. Here. Up, Fuzzhead. Up. That's what I call thankful.
We all had something to be thankful for. Being alive, for one. And I had a few private things as well. And how.
There's one thing I love. It's leftover turkey. There's nothing like pickle juice. Kosher. When you're grown up, kid.
The old man was one of that tiny band of gourmets who truly understand the mystique of pickle juice. Life without kosher dills is no life at all.
How come we didn't get the Buick?
That turkey suit was really something, wasn't it?
Yeah, he's wearing it in bed.
Little bugger.
Well, how come we didn't get the Buick?
I changed my mind. I got the valve ground on the Hornet instead. She's got a few more years left in her.
Roadmaster's burn oil anyway.
Care for wingtip?
Yeah, don't mind if I do. I think I'll take this with me upstairs. I'm beat. I'm gonna hit the sack.
How was the ball game last night?
Oh, not bad. We killed them. 86 or 48.
Mm-hmm. Sobek must have been hot, huh?
36 points.
See you in the morning, Jockstrap.
Yeah, night.
Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Those Thanksgivings at home were what Thanksgiving is all about. Mothers, fathers, brothers, the family dog, and time like a gray shadow pursuing us all. But those Thanksgiving drumsticks when you were young were the sweetest of all. Even time can't rob you of those memories. They are forever.